Okay, good afternoon. I'm your moderator today. My name's Andy Sharp. I'm from Bloomberg. Welcome to the FCCJ. Can I remind you as well to keep your cell phones turned off during the press conference? And it's my pleasure to introduce our main guest today. It's Mr. Kazuo Shii. He's the Executive Committee Chairperson of the Japanese Communist Party. And next to Shii-san is our interpreter today, Mary Joyce. So for 15 years, I'll sit down. Today's speaker, Mr. Shii, has led the Japanese Communist Party, never wavering from his opposition to the political mainstream. In last December's election, the party more than doubled its seats in the lower house as voters turned to the party in protest at Prime Minister Abe's security, nuclear, and tax policies. So all eyes now are on what Japan's opposition will do in their bid to bring down the government, and whether they can build on the popular popular anger against Abe's pushing through of security legislation, a mood exemplified this summer by the protests we saw led by the SEALS movement. Under Mr. Shii, the JCP is proposing a coalition to fight for power and repeal the cabinet decision of July 2014 that opened the way to the passage of the legislation to strengthen Japan's military, or as Mr. Shii calls them, the war bills. And just a reminder that Mr. Shii has been to the club more than 10 times in his 15 years. And as a fair, balanced and neutral press club, we invite all leaders of all political parties, and yet we have to have Mr. Abe come. Okay, so without further ado, Mr. Shii is going to speak for 20 minutes or so. 40 minutes, and then we'll open the floor to Q&A. So, please, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Kazuo Shii.
Good afternoon, and thank you very much for inviting me to be here today. My name is Shii Kazuo of the Japanese Communist Party. In the early hours of September 19, the Abe administration and the government forced through this new security laws, which I call the war laws. On the afternoon of the same day, the Japan Communist Party held its fourth Central Committee plenum, and at this time we decided to make a proposal for a national coalition government to repeal the war legislation. The full text of this proposal has been distributed to you today. Our proposal is based on the following three foundations or pillars.
第一は戦争法安保法制廃止、安倍政権打倒の戦いをさらに発展させようという戦いの呼びかけです。
The first is a call for a struggle to intensify developments and the struggle in order to repeal the war legislation, the security legislation, and also to defeat the Abe government.
第二は戦争法廃止で一致する政党団体個人が共同して国民連合政府を作ろうという政府の提唱であります。
And the second pillar of this proposal is for all parties, organizations, and individuals to work together towards the repeal of the war legislation, and to do this in order to, a governmental proposal to create a national coalition government.
そして第3は、戦争法廃止の国民連合政府で一致する野党が国政選挙で選挙協力を行おうという呼びかけであります。
And the third call being made in this proposal is for opposition parties to work together under the same banner of this national coalition government to repeal the war legislation to undertake cooperation in the national elections.
まあ、すでに提案は大きな反響を呼んでおります。
The proposal has already been very welcome, warmly welcomed.
私たちはこの提案をもって各界各分野の方々との懇談を続けておりますが、これまでにない広範な方々から賛同と激励の声が寄せられていることは大変に嬉しいことであります。
We have recently been conducting discussions with representatives of various fields and spheres on this issue. And within this, we have found very much an extremely broad range of people who are giving their support and also voices of encouragement to this, which is something, of course, to be welcomed.
最近の JNN の世論調査では、共産党が呼びかけた選挙協力について、37% の方が期待すると。答えております。
In a recent public opinion poll conducted by JNN, 37% of respondents said that they are placing hopes or expectations on the election cooperation proposed by the Communist Party.
野党は協力をという声が一つの流れとなりつつあります。
And the voice calling for cooperation amongst opposition parties is becoming one very strong movement now.
これを文字通りの国民的な流れにしていくことがこの提案を実現する最大の鍵だと考えております。
And making this voice exactly into a national movement will be the key to, or the biggest key to realizing this proposal.
私たちはそのためにあらゆる努力を続けたいと決意しております。
And so we are determined to continue all efforts in order to succeed in this.
この提案をもっての野党各党との話し合いも始まりました。
We have begun our discussions about this proposal with the representatives of each of the opposition parties.
私は民主党、社民党、生活の党との最初の党首会談を行いましたが、全体として良いスタートが切れたと考えています。
I have already conducted meetings with the leaders of the Democratic Party of Japan, the Social Democrats, and also the People's Life Party. And within this, I believe that in general, we have made a very positive start to this.
維新の党とも党首会談が行われることになると思います。
And I believe that we will also be holding a meeting with the leader of the Restoration Party.
まあ、様々な困難もありますが、互いの信頼関係を大切にして、粘り強く話し合いを続け、合意できるように誠実に努力したいと考えております。
Well, of course, there will be various difficulties on the way. I believe that if we value trust in each other and also continue in a very determined and sincere way these discussions, then we can make efforts towards agreement on these issues.
さて、メディアの報道では、私たちが選挙協力を呼びかけたことに注目が集まっています。
In regards to reports in the media, our proposal or call for cooperation in the elections is receiving great interest.
しかし、私たちの提案の一番の要は、国民連合政府という政府を提唱したことにあります。
However, at the core of our proposal, the most important part is actually the proposal for a government, in other words, for the national coalition government.
もちろん、国民連合政府という名称は仮称でありまして、みんなで決めればいいと考えております。
Of course, this name is just a suggestion, and this is something which can be decided upon by all those involved.
なぜ国民連合政府か。
Why a national coalition government?
一言で言えば、本気で日本の政治を立て直そうとすれば、今どうしてもこうした政府を実現する必要がある。これは私たちの考えであります。
And to put this very simply, well, what is needed at the moment in order to really rebuild the politics in Japan seriously is the realization of such a government. And our belief that this is necessary is what's driving. There are three points which I would like to emphasize today.
第一に、
First of all, is if we are indeed serious about repealing the war law, the security legislation, and also taking back, regaining Japan's political constitutionalism and also democracy, then a government to realize this, to implement this, is needed. As has already been made clear within the debates in the Diet, the war legislation tramples upon Article 9 of the Constitution and is actually going against the Constitution as a law which would make Japan into a country which can once again fight wars overseas.
それを進めたやり方も 60年余にわたる政府の憲法解釈を一内閣の選断で覆すという立憲主義を乱暴に破壊するものでした。
And the process which has put this forward as well is actually overturning by one cabinet itself, unilaterally overturning the constitutional interpretation which has been held by the Japanese governments for 60 years until now. So this is something completely destroying the constitutionalism.
戦争法は内容でもやり方でも二重に憲法を破壊するものであって、この法律ばかりは与党の数の暴力で強行成立させられたからといって、それを許したままにしておくことは決してできません。
And so this war legislation, in both its contents and also the process in which it was built forward, is actually destroying the constitution in two ways at the same time. And by the government using its, well, violence in its numbers which it holds, being railroaded through. And this is something which, of course, we cannot sit back and forgive.
私たちは戦争法廃止の新たな戦いを国民と共に大きく発展させていきたいと。
We are determined to develop, together with the people of Japan, a new struggle in order to repeal this war legislation. So what is necessary in order to repeal this law?
廃止を求める勢力が衆議院と参議院で多数を獲得し、廃止法案を可決させることが最も不可欠です。
First of all, in order to abolish this war legislation, we need to have a majority in both the House of Representatives and also of councillors, which calls for a movement which would call for the abolition. So we need to have these numbers in both of the houses and also to adopt a proposal to repeal these laws.
同時にそれだけでは足りません。
However, this is not alone sufficient.
それだけでは集団的自衛権行使を容認した昨年の 7月1日の閣議決定が残ります。
Because the reason for this is even if this is done, then the issue of the cabinet decision of the 1st of July last year, which permits the use of the right to collective self-defense, will still remain.
これが残る限り、自衛隊の海外派兵の大きな火種が残ったままです。
And if this is still remaining, then this also leaves us, of course, with the great issue of the potential dispatch overseas of the self-defense forces. So this would lead to, of course, a continuation of this very wrong constitutional reinterpretation and also neglect of the very constitutionalism. So within such an extraordinary situation, what is necessary is to actually retract this cabinet decision.
そして戦争法を廃止、閣議決定の撤回という二つの仕事を本気でやろうとすれば、安倍政権の下では元より不可能です。
And if we are indeed serious about achieving these two points, the repeal of the war legislation and the withdrawing of the cabinet decision, then this is impossible to be done under the Abe administration.
それを実行する新しい政府を作ることがどうしても必要になります。
Meaning that is, it is of course necessary to create a new government which can actually implement this.
第二に、本気で安倍政権を打倒しようとすれば、それに代わってどういう政権を作るのか。
And the second point is if we are indeed serious about defeating the Abe government, then we need to also think about what kind of administration should replace this.
安倍政権を打倒した後の政権構想を野党が責任を持って示すことがどうしても必要となります。
Therefore, it is necessary for the opposition parties to take responsibility and put forward a proposal for a structure of a new administration which could take the place following the defeat of the Abe government.
野党間に国政の基本問題での政策的一致が存在する場合には、本格的な野党連立政権を作ることが現実的な課題となるでしょう。
So in the case where there is agreement upon very basic or key issues and key policies within the government amongst the opposition parties, then real steps towards the creation of a national coalition government can become a realistic challenge or a realistic thing to introduce.
しかし現実にはそうした条件は存在しません。
However, that kind of situation is not existing currently.
だからといって野党間で基本政策が一致するまで待つわけにはいきません。
However, of course, we cannot sit back and wait until there is full agreement on basic policies amongst all of the opposition parties.
それでは安倍政権がいつまでも続くことになります。
Because that would mean that the Abe administration would continue unlimitedly.
それではどうするか。
Therefore, what should we do?
私たちの提案は、野党間で政策的な相違点があるもとでも、それを横に置いて、戦争法を廃止、立憲主義の回復、この一点で、この国民的大義で一致するすべての政党、団体、個人が共同して、連立政府を作ろうというものです。
Therefore, our proposal is that even when there are differences in policy amongst the opposition parties, these should be put to the side. And on the two main points of repealing the war legislation and reclaiming Japan's constitutionalism, all political parties, groups, and also individuals should work together in order to create a national coalition government.
よく勝利を捨てて大道にという言葉があります。
Often people say, well, put something big aside while you are looking towards the certain point you're working for.
私たちの提案は大義を横に置いて大道にというものであります。
However, our proposal is also looking at what needs to be put aside, but also the most important part as we are going forward.
この政府は、この一点での合意を基礎にした政府ですから、その政局は暫定的なものとなります。
The government which we are proposing is, of course, coming together on the agreement on one particular point. Therefore, it is in nature a temporary government.
すなわちこの政府は、その任務を達成した時点で解散・総選挙を行い、その先の日本の進路については、国民の審判を踏まえて選択すべきだと考えます。
Therefore, I believe that this national coalition government, once it does achieve the goals which it puts forward at its creation, its next step should be to dissolve, to call a national election, and to allow the people from there to judge and choose how to go forward.
そのことを私たちは提案の中に率直に明記しています。
And we include this very directly and honestly within our proposal.
今、国民の中で安倍政権の退陣、安倍政権の打倒という声は大きく広がりつつあります。
Amongst the people of Japan, calls for deposing or defeating Abe and his government are very much growing.
それでは安倍政権を打倒した後にどのような政権を作るのか。
But what kind of government should we create after defeating Prime Minister Abe?
それはそれぞれの野党に問われている問題です。
This is something which is being questioned of all of the opposition parties.
それはまた多くの国民にも問われている問題だと思います。
And this is, of course, I believe, also something which is being asked of the citizens too.
打倒した後も、自民党内の政権のたらい回しで、 安倍政権の阿流政権に交代するだけでは何の意味もありません。
Of course, there would be no meaning at all if the Abe administration was defeated, but it would be followed by another Liberal Democratic Party government, which would just follow on in different ways what Abe had been doing.
私たちは国民連合政府という政権構想が現時点で安倍政権に代わる唯一の現実的で合理的な政権構想だと確信するものです。
We strongly believe that the proposal for a national coalition government is the only currently existing realistic and logical proposal to replace this.
第三に、本気で野党の選挙協力を成功させ、自民党公明党を打ち負かし、安倍政権を退陣に追い込もうとすれば、野党の側が明確な国民的大義を掲げることがどうしても必要となります。
We believe that if we are indeed serious about working together to succeed in cooperation at elections amongst the opposition parties, to defeat the LDP and Kōmeitō, and also to force the Abe government into resignation, then we need to put forward a clear national cause for the opposition to be working together with the people towards.
昨年12月の総選挙で、私たちは沖縄1区から4区までの全てで選挙協力を行い、全てで自民党候補を打ち破って勝利を勝ち取りました。
In the national or the general elections of December last year, we were successful in working together for cooperation at the elections within all the four electoral divisions in Okinawa from 1 through to 4 to defeat all of the LDP candidates and be successful in this.
なぜ勝利ができたか。
Why was this successful?
その最大の要因は辺野古新基地反対というオール沖縄の声、県民的な大義を高々と掲げて戦い抜いたことにありました。
And the greatest reason for this is the fact that there was a cause held by all of the population of the prefecture, that is all Okinawa, working against the creation of an or construction of a new military base at Henoko to raise this cause, this banner, and struggle together and work together under this.
野党が選挙協力を行ったとしても、自公に打ち勝つのが容易でないことは明らかです。
Of course, it is clear that even with cooperation in the elections by opposition parties, it will not be easy to defeat the LDP and Kōmeitō.
勝利するためには国民的大義をはっきりと示すことがどうしても必要です。
In order to be successful in this, what is very necessary or completely necessary for this is to be able to put forward a very clear national cause.
私たちは戦争法を廃止、立憲主義回復、国民連合政府という国民的大義を明確に示し、その下で野党が結束して戦ってこそ、勝利をつかむことは可能になると考えます。
So we believe that by making very clear the national cause of repealing the war legislation, regaining constitutionalism, and creating a national coalition government,and working together to collaborate and become one under this, it will be possible to have success.
野党が共同して政権を担うというところまで互いに腹を固めてこそ、そしてその本気度が国民に伝わってこそ、激しい選挙戦を勝ち抜くことができる。これは私たちの考えです。
So we believe that if the opposition parties can indeed collaborate in such a way and form a new government administration and be determined about this, and also for this seriousness of them to be conveyed and fully understood and shared by the people, then it will be possible to have success within even very difficult election struggles.
要は野党が本気になって日本の政治を変える志を持つかどうか。
In other words, whether the opposition parties really have the strong and serious will to change the politics of Japan or not.
私たち野党に問われている問題の核心はここにあると考えます。
This is at the heart of what is now being questioned of us, the opposition of Japan.
本気で立憲主義を取り戻そうとすれば、本気で安倍政権を打倒しようとすれば、本気で選挙協力を成功させようとすれば、国民連合政府の旗を掲げることがどうしても必要となるのではないでしょうか。
And if we are indeed serious about regaining Japan's constitutionalism, defeating the Abe government, and having cooperation in the elections, then what is necessary for this is the National Coalition Government. So this is our proposal.
ある media からの取材で、政策的に違う部分がある政党が暫定的な政権であれ、政権を共にすることには無理があるという批判に、どう答えるかという質問がありました。
In a media interview, I was asked the question of what my response would be to whether it is indeed possible or wouldn't it be impossible for political parties with very different policies to work together even in a temporary government.
こうした質問に対して私はまず、立憲主義の回復という課題は、あれこれの政策問題とは次元の違う、この国の根幹土台を立て直す大問題だということを強調したいと思います。
And what I would like to emphasize in response to this is the issue of regaining Japan's constitutionalism is something on a completely different level to other policy issues. It is at the very heart or foundation of Japan itself, and therefore this is a question which is of a completely different situation.
どんなに国会で多数を持つ政権であっても、憲法の枠組みは守らなければならない。これが立憲主義の要請です。
And no matter what government and what majority they may have within the Diet, the framework of Japan's constitution must be preserved, protected. And this is indeed at the heart of constitutionalism.
ところが現状はこの根幹土台が崩されているのです。
However, the current situation at this is that these foundations, these roots are actually crumbling.
それをそのままにしておけば、日本は無法国家になってしまいます。
And if this is let to be, then actually Japan will become a country of no law.
独裁政治になってしまいます。
It will become dictatorial politics.
すなわち日本の政治は、あれこれの政策を論じる土台そのものが損なわれかねないという非常事態になります。
So this is actually an emergency situation where the very foundation on which we debate, on which we discuss various policy issues, could actually be lost.
立憲主義を取り戻す。という課題は政権を作る上でこれ以上の憲政上の大義はないと言ってよいほどの大きな国民的大義を持つ課題であるということを私は強調したいと思います。
Therefore, I would like to emphasize that regaining Japan's constitutionalism and this challenge, or this issue itself, when we are looking at creating a new government, there is actually no greater cause amongst Japan or amongst the constitution and politics, and nothing greater than this for which the people and government can work together for.
それではその他の国政上の課題をどうするか。
So what should be done about the issues of other national political situations or policies?
私たちは立憲主義の回復という国民的大義で大同団結が図られるならば、その他の国政上の問題についても、そういう点は横に置き、一致点で合意形成を図るという原則で対応していくことが可能になると考えております。
We believe that if indeed we can all come together under this one common national cause of regaining constitutionalism, then other political issues can be indeed put to the side, differences put to the side, and work together to form agreement and formation of this upon this one point. And this can be the foundation or the principle on which we can work forwards with.
例えば、日米安保条約についてどうするか。
So, well, what should we do or consider about, for example, the US-Japan Security Pact?
私たちは廃棄という方針ですが、国民連合政府の対応としては、凍結するということになります。
So, of course, our party is of the position that this should be abolished. However, under a national coalition government, the steps forward should be, would be to freeze this.
凍結とはどういうことか。
And so, what does freezing imply?
戦争法廃止を前提として、第一に、現行の条約と法律の枠内で対応する。
Well, the first step of this would be on the principle of working to abolish the war legislation, to work within the framework of the current treaty and the current law.
第二に、現状からの改悪はやらない。
And the second point, to not make any changes which would worsen the situation.
第三に政権として廃棄を目指す措置は取らないということであります。
And the third point would be that as a government, no steps or no measures would be taken aiming for the abolition of this treaty.
野党間の政策上の相違点についてはこういう精神で対応していきたいと私たちは考えております。
And so we believe that this is the kind of spirit in which dealing with various differences in policies and positions within the parties coming together should be taken.
もちろん一点では前向きな仕事にも取り組んでいきます。
Of course, within coming together in agreement, we would work together in a forward-looking way.
まあ重要なことは野党5党には安倍内閣の不信任案を共同で提出したことに示されるように安倍政権の退陣打倒という点では政治的一致がすでに存在するということです。
And what is important here is, as demonstrated by the fact that the vote of no confidence in the cabinet was put forward together by all five opposition parties, actually coming together on the point of defeat of the Abe administration and resignation is something which politically there is already a united agreement upon.
そういう政治的一致を基礎に置けば、安倍政権の民意を無視したさまざまな暴走に対しても、これを許さず転換を図るという立場に立って、さまざまな協力の一致点が見出されるのではないでしょうか。
And so based on this point and this kind of circumstances with this at the foundation, this would mean that the steps being taken by Prime Minister Abe to ignore the people's will, the people's voices and push forward various steps which he has made is something which would not be allowed to happen. And in order to bring change, then look for ways to cooperate and we would be able to find ways to cooperate in various aspects.
一例ですが、例えば労働法制の問題ではこの政権の下で、前向きの改革が実行できるのではないかと考えております。
One example would be actually on the issue of labor issues. I believe that it would be possible for positive steps to be taken together in such a coalition.
まあこういう立場で政策的な調整を行えば国民に責任を持った政権運営を行うことは十分に可能だと私は考えております。
So I believe that if such a spirit and such steps could be taken, then in a way that is taking responsibility for the people, it would be possible to cooperate in these ways also.
最後に、国民連合政府が掲げる立憲主義を取り戻すという課題が、国民の皆さん一人一人にとってどういう意味を持つのかについて述べたいと思います。
Finally, I would like to speak on the issue of what regaining constitutionalism, as is being called for by this proposed national coalition government, what meaning this would have for each and every individual citizen.
今安倍政権が行っている政治の特徴を一言で言うならば、国家の暴走によって個人の尊厳を踏みにじる政治と特徴づけることができるのではないでしょうか。
If I were to put in one phrase the characteristics of the current Abe administration and the politics which they are undertaking, this would be for pushing forward by the state and trampling on the respect and dignity of the individual in its politics.
それは戦争法でも、沖縄問題でも、原発問題でも、労働問題でも、税と社会保障の問題でも、あらゆる問題で言えることです。
This is something which could be said in all fields, including the war legislation, the Okinawa issue, nuclear power, labor, tax, and social welfare.
それはまた、この政権が突然持ち出した1億総活躍社会なるスローガン、官房長官のたくさん産んで国家に貢献という言葉にも表れています。
And I believe that this can also be seen in, for example, the slogan which was suddenly put forward by this administration, the society with all 100 million people plus dynamically engaged, or also the comment by Chief Cabinet Secretary Suga saying, well, to have many babies and contribute to the state.
国家のために働け、国家のために子供を産め、GDP 600兆円を達成せよ。
So to work for the purpose of the state, to give birth to many children for the purpose of the state, to contribute in this way.
国家と個人の関係がまさに逆立ちしているのではないでしょうか。
And the relationship between the state and this individual in this way is actually being reversed from what it should be.
国家のために国民があるのではありません。
The people are not there for the purpose of the state.
国民の幸せのためにこそ国家があるのではないでしょうか。
Is not the state there for the purpose of making the people happy?
それは実は日本国憲法第13条が国家に命じていることでもあります。
This is actually something which is included in Article 13 of the Japanese Constitution.
この条項では冒頭に、すべて国民は個人として尊重されるとあります。
The beginning of this article states that all of the people shall be respected as individuals.
私は個人の尊重、個人の尊厳こそ近代民主主義の原点の中の原点でに他ならないと考えるものであります。
And I believe that indeed the respect and dignity of the individual is the very foundations of modern democracy.
国民連合政府が目標とする立憲主義の回復とは、すべての国民一人一人の個人の尊厳を守り、大切にする社会を作ることに他なりません。
And the recovery of constitutionalism, which is the goal of the national coalition government proposed, is actually very much for the purpose of protecting the respect of each and every individual person, and also creating a society which values this.
この間、戦争法案に反対して立ち上がった多くの国民は、まさに一人一人の意思で個人の尊厳をかけて立ち上がりました。
And of course, each and every individual person in Japan who was standing up to voice their opposition to the war legislation was there for their own will and also their own dignity.
これらの人々が広く手を結んで作る国民連合政府は、文字通りすべての国民の個人の尊厳を守り、大切にする社会への歴史的一歩を踏み出す政府になると、私は確信を持って言いたいと思います。
And if each and all of these people are able to come together to take up hands together in order to create a national coalition government, this would indeed serve to protect the dignity of each and every individual in Japan and be a historical first step towards creating a society which does indeed value this. I am determined and believe this strongly.
ご清聴ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much.
Okay, wait for this.Thank you very much, Shii-san, for your speech there. Now we're going to go to some questions. Just a few notices. The priority will go to the working press. And could people give their name, their affiliation, and limit themselves to one question and no long speeches, please? Okay, so the first question here, please.
Gebhard Hilscher from Germany Freelance. My question is, the important thing is how you get the party together, so to speak, with the other parties. Could you tell us, can you tell us, for instance, you have already met party leaders of other parties, what sort of reaction the Minshuto side made to your proposal? Do you see a chance that you can agree with them because they are the largest opposition party at the moment, but they're small, too small to do it by themselves?
まず各党の党首の方々とこの間会談を行ってまいりました。
First of all, I have been meeting with the leaders of the other opposition parties in recent days.
民主党岡田代表との会談では、まず私から、戦争法廃止の国民連合政府の提案を説明いたしました。
And in my meeting with Mr. Okada of the Democratic Party of Japan, first of all, I explained to him our proposal for the National Coalition Government to repeal the war legislation.
岡田代表からは思い切った提案に敬意を表しますというご発言があり、提案の内容について熱心かつ真剣な質問あるいは意見を寄せられ、私が一つ一つに丁寧に私たちの考えをお伝えいたしました。
And in my discussion with Mr. Okada, first of all, his response was to express respect for this proposal and thank for it being made. And in regards to the content, he posed several very serious and also quite passionate questions about the contents of this proposal as well, to which I responded one by one.
まあ、両党首として引き続き話し合っていくことで一致しました。
And within that meeting, we agreed as the leaders of the two parties to continue our discussions further together.
大変良いスタートが切れたのではないかと私は感じております。
And so I feel that this was actually a very good start for these discussions.
それから社民党の吉田党首との会談では、私の説明に対して先方から大変大胆で踏み込んだ提案をいただいた。前向きに受け止めて積極的な選挙協力ができるようしっかり議論を進めていきたい。さまざまな困難はあろうが連立政権の方向性も賛同するとのご発言がありました。
And in regards with my meeting with Mr. Yoshida of the Social Democrats, first of all, there was expressed the position that the proposal is very ambitious but also deep or very in-depth proposal, and it would be considered positively. That discussion would be continued in order to consider what kind of cooperation would be possible in the election and how to make that happen. While there would, of course, be various difficulties in the process to realize this, there was an expression of support for this proposal for a national coalition government.
まあ、大変心強いスタートです。
Which is, of course, a very encouraging beginning.
生活の党の小沢代表との会談では、私の説明に対して、小沢代表からは従来の方針を大転換した共産党の決断を高く評価する、手を携え選挙に勝ち政権を打ち立てるという目標に向かって自分も努力したいとのご発言がありました。
And in my meeting with Mr. Ozawa representing the People's Life Party, first of all, he praised the fact that the Communist Party of Japan had actually made such a step away from its previous way or previous policy in order to make this proposal, and made his expression to see how what could be done to win together, and that he himself would also personally make efforts in order to do this.
まあ、両党が全面的に合意に至ったことは大変嬉しいことです。
And so, of course, it is a very pleasing thing that there has been such agreement from both of these parties.
維新の党の松野代表とは、近く会談することになると思います。
And in regards to the leader of the Restoration Party, Matsuno, soon I will be having a meeting to discuss this.
岡田代表について言いますと、彼のブログの中で、共産党との政権協力はハードルが高いが、候補者調整は重要だと述べた上で、まあ、Cさんは政治家として、人間として、私は信頼していい人だと、今までの長い交流の中で感じています。しっかり話し合っていきたいということが述べられておりました。
And actually, in the blog published by Mr. Okada of the DPJ, he has written that while there are very high hurdles in regards to cooperation in this way with the Communist Party, he does indeed believe that such kind of coordination is very important. And he also wrote in there that both as a person and as a politician, he places great trust in me, in Shii, and also through our long exchange and many years of working together, hopes to continue also having further or deepening discussions on this issue.
私も長い交流の中で岡田さんに同じような信頼を感じております。
And I personally also have the same trust in Mr. Okada thanks to our long relationship.
互いに信頼感を大切にして、誠意を持って話し合っていけば、合意できる可能性は大いにあると考えております。
And therefore, I believe that with this mutual trust and also mutual sincerity, if we can continue discussions in such a way, it is indeed possible to be able to realize such cooperation as I am proposing.
まあ、いろいろな困難はあるとは思いますが、話し合いがスタートしたところですので、どうか、温かく見守っていただけるとありがたいと思います。
Of course, there will be many difficulties along the way. However, I believe that now we have started these discussions, started this process in way, so I hope that you can continue to pay attention at how it progresses from now.
Okay, Joel.
My name is Joel Legendre from French TV5 World and RTL. Nice to see you again, sir. In your text, page 3, In the paragraph, the one before the end, you say, let's create a hopeful future of our nation by exercising our own sovereign power as the citizens of Japan. And you mentioned the upsurge of the people opposing the war bills recently in the last months. We've seen the appearance of a very quick reacting force, which was the students. And it's a paradox, also the old people, the elder Japanese. So in some way they've been quicker than you and some others of the opposition in getting people together for some strategy. My question is, how is your country far from being sovereign power, and what ideas of democracy do you want to emphasize? No, because I mean, for 70 years we've had a country who was basically led, as some commentators said, by the party from outside. So how would you like to become a real democracy? Thank you.
この間ですね、国民の中でこの安保法、戦争法に反対する戦後かつてない新しい国民運動が起こっていることに私たちは大変励まされております。
First of all, we are very much encouraged by the unprecedented opposition and actions we are seeing by the citizens of Japan in opposition to the security or the war legislation.
その中でとりわけ若い皆さん、女性の方々が素晴らしい役割を発揮してされていることは日本の未来にとって大きな希望だと思います。
And especially, I believe that the active involvement of both young people and also women has a great hope for the future of Japan.
もちろん年配の方の大奮闘もあると思います。
And of course, the contribution of the elderly population as well.
学生の皆さんと話しておりますと、皆さんおっしゃるのは、これまで、自分の父親、あるいはおじいさん、おばあさん、父母や祖父母の世代が、守り、自分たちに伝えてくれた憲法 の平和主義、民主主義、立憲主義、これをしっかり自分たちで受け継ぎたいということを言います。
And in discussions, when talking with the young students who are involved in this movement, one thing which many of them do say is, until now, well, their fathers, their grandparents, their great-grandparents had protected and passed on this pacifism, democracy, and constitutionalism of the constitution to us until now.
主権国家ということがご質問ありました。
And in your question, you asked about Japan as a sovereign state.
この安保法、戦争法というのは、もともとですね、新ガイドラインの具体化として進められているものです。
This war legislation, the security legislation, is being pushed forward also in line with the new guidelines which have been put forward by the government.
で、この根源は米国からの要請に応えて、それに迎合して日本を作り変えるという日本の主権を事実上放棄するという動きがあると考えています。
And I believe that actually at the basis of this, well, it is in a way an answer to requests from the United States, and therefore changing Japan in this way is actually abandoning the sovereignty of Japan as a state.
ですから、戦争法を廃止する戦いは、日本の主権を取り戻す戦いでもあります。
Therefore, the struggle to repeal the war legislation is also a struggle to recover the sovereignty of Japan.
民主主義とは何かと。いうご質問がありました。
And in regards to democracy and what it means.
国会前の抗議行動では、若い皆さんが民主主義って何だというコールをしています。
Within the protests occurring in front of the Diet Building, one of the calls of many of the young activists was, "Tell me what democracy looks like."
彼らはこの問題を深く考えています。
I believe they are very deeply considering this issue.
安倍首相は選挙で一旦多数を得たら、最後に何でも多数決で決めていい。国民の声がどうであろうが、選挙で一旦多数を得たら何でもやっていい。これが民主主義だと言ってはばからない。
Prime Minister Abe is, or his view of democracy, how he is going forward with things, is saying that, well, if a majority is held by the government, then it can decide anything based on this majority. It can go forward with anything that it likes while completely neglecting the voices of the people.
しかし民主主義というのはそういうものではないと思います。
But I believe that this is not indeed what democracy is.
たとえ選挙で多数を得たものであっても、それに対する自分の政治に対する異論や批判には真摯に向き合う。
I believe that even if there is a majority success in the elections, it is necessary to continue to listen to the voices of those who are in opposition to your politics.
誠実に語り合う。
To have sincere dialogue.
そういう普段のプロセスが民主主義じゃないでしょうか。
And this normal process itself should be what democracy really is.
今若い方々が今の安倍政権のやり方は単に憲法の平和主義、立憲主義を壊すとともに、そういう民主主義の真っ当なあり方を壊すものだと批判しているのは、私は非常に深い批判だと思います。
So I believe that the criticism of young people today about the methods of Prime Minister Abe, not only on the issues of the pacifism and constitutionalism, but also the criticism of his way of going about things and the very nature of the democracy, I believe this is indeed a very deep and important criticism.
ですから私たちはこの国民連合政府を作ることは、日本に本当の民主主義を取り戻す第一歩にもなると考えております。
Therefore, we believe that the creation of a national coalition government would indeed be the first step towards creating real democracy for Japan.
Yes, sir. We'll get to you guys. Plenty of time.
Siegfried Knittel for the Austrian newspaper, The Standard. I think Mr. Okada is not in favor of abolishing the security treaty with the United States. So how can you convince Mr. Okada and the majority of the Minchito people and even the people of the Ishinoto to abolish the security treaty? And the second point is, do you have a kind of a time schedule when to how to make a new government? I think the lower house is now elected until 2008. So how do you think you can replace the Chiminto government before 2008?
2018? 2018. 2018. 2018. 2018. 2018. 2018.
In regards to the US-Japan Security Treaty, the Democratic Party of Japan and the Communist Party have, of course, different positions.
どのように説得するかというご質問でした。
And you asked about, well, how we would hope to convince them.
私はこれは違いは違いとして互いに尊重し、先ほど言ったように横に置くということが一番現実的なやり方だと思っています。
I believe that actually the most realistic way to go forward with this is on this point to acknowledge and respect the differences of the two parties and put this aside.
これ違いをなくして一致させようとしたら、いつまでたっても合意はできません。
If we try to get rid of the differences in this policy, of course this would be continuing forever.
民主党とは日米安保条約については立場は異なっていますが、民主党も含む野党5党が安保法、戦争法にこう一致してこの成立を阻止するために共同して戦ったという事実があります。
And of course, while there is a different policy or position on the US-Japan Security Treaty between the two parties, we have experienced in recent months actually cooperation between the Democratic Party and all of the opposition parties, in fact, to work together to prevent the passing of the war legislation.
そして5党が一致して安倍内閣の不信任案を提出したという事実があります。
And there was, of course, also the fact of the joint submission of the vote of no confidence in Mr. Abe by the five opposition parties.
この安倍内閣不信任案の提出を決めた9月18日の野党党首会談では、今後どういう事態になろうとも 憲法の平和主義、立憲主義、民主主義を守るために協力しようということも確認しました。
And this was on September 18, of course, when the vote of no confidence in the Abe cabinet was passed. On that day, when we had the meeting with the leaders of all of the opposition parties, we did reach agreement on no matter what would happen next from there, we would continue collaboration on the issues of pacifism, constitutionalism, and democracy.
私はこの野党の党首会談の席上で、もしもこの安倍内閣不信任案が可決されたら、ここにいる野党5党が、そしてそれに賛成した人たちで連立政権を構成することになりますねと言いました。
And actually at the time of that meeting I said, well, if this vote of no confidence was to be passed, then those of us who are here today together and together with those who are agreeing as well would be creating indeed a coalition.
不信任案を提出するというのは論理的にはそういうことになります。
And well, in theory, this is of course what submitting the vote of no confidence means.
まあそういう野党共闘の積み重ねの上に今回の提案は生まれております。 作りました。
And so we created this proposal based on the experience of such collaboration between the five opposition parties until now.
ですから日米安保条約そのものについての見解は異なっても、この提案の線での合意は可能だと考えております。
Therefore, I believe that even if we are of different positions in regards to the U.S.-Japan Security Treaty, it is possible to reach agreement on this one main point and work together in this way as a temporary step.
それからスケジュールの問題です。
And in regards to the schedule?
私たちの提案では、速やかな解散総選挙を安倍政権に求め、それに追い込んでいくということを述べています。
Within our proposal, we call for in the near future for the dissolution and call for a national election.
これに安倍政権が応じない場合には、来年の7月の参議院選挙が非常に重要な戦いになります。
However, of course, if this is not successful and if Prime Minister Abe's government does not call for this, then the July House of Councillors elections next year will be incredibly important.
この参議院選挙に向けて、私たちの提案の方向で政治的な合意、そして政権合意、選挙協力の合意、この3つの合意をぜひ達成して、そのもとに選挙を戦いたいと考えております。
Therefore, we very much hope that the direction which is put forth within our proposal, having agreement on the three main points amongst the opposition parties to work together, can be achieved in time to fight the struggle at the time of the election based on this joint effort towards the House of Councillors elections next year.
特に32ある一人区の戦いが非常に重要になってきます。
The elections in particularly the 32 single seat divisions within Japan will be extremely important.
私たちとしてはこの32の一人区のすべてで、野党が相互に選挙協力を行い、自民党をすべて打ち負かして勝利を勝ち取ると、そのぐらいの構えで臨みたいと考えております。
And we indeed want to set our sights so high as to work to defeat LDP candidates in all of these 32 single-seat divisions in order to have cooperation in the election by all of the opposition parties to achieve this.
そういう勝利が勝ち取ることができれば、自公は参議院で過半数を大きく割ることになるでしょう。
And if we could be successful in this, then this would also mean a division in terms of the majority held by the LDP in Komeito.
解散総選挙に次のステップで追い込んでいくことになります。
And this would be bringing them closer towards the next step of calling for the dissolution and a national election.
そういう流れを作っていければいいと願ってます。
And so this is the kind of process which we are hoping to be able to create.
Okay. Linda, please, then Michael, Jimbo-san, and then you.
Linda Sieg from Reuters. It may be, you may feel it's too early to answer this question, but I think if the parties were to fight in an election on this sort of joint platform, you would be asked, and I think you have been asked already in some cases, would, in terms of the composition of the coalition government, would the Communist Party insist on having cabinet member or members in the coalition government? Because I believe this might be a serious hurdle, not only to the other opposition parties, but to some voters who would perhaps agree with opposition to the Abe administration, but have concerns about having communist members in the cabinet. Thank you.
あの国民連合政府が作られた場合に日本共産党がどういう形で関与するかというあのご質問ですが、あの私の提案では、閣内協力あるいは閣外協力、閣内か閣外かという条件を最初から設定しているわけではありません。
In regards to our proposal for the National Coalition Government, we are not putting forward any conditions, shall we say, on cooperation either inside or outside of the cabinet in what kind of a National Coalition Government would be formed.
あの、私の提案では、あの、閣内協力でなければいけないと最初から言ってるわけではないんです。
And so from our initial proposal, we have not said anything about whether there would necessarily have to be as a condition certain makeup of the cabinet.
それは選択肢がいろいろあるでしょう。
And I believe there are many different options for this.
その時点で最良の選択肢を取ることになると思います。
And we would of course look at the various different options and take what would be the best for going forward.
Okay, Michael, please.
Michael Penner, the Shingetsu News Agency. Prime Minister Abe was Prime Minister once before from 2006 to 2007, and it was a highly unsuccessful 1 year in office. But then after 5 years out of power and his defeat, he came back a much more seasoned and a much more strategically intelligent politician than he had been before. He led with issues like Abenomics, which were popular with the public. He was much more... defended his own people much better than he did in his first administration. So he seemed to have learned lessons during from his defeat. What lessons do you think the opposition parties should learn from the 3 years of the Democratic Party of Japan government? How would an opposition government that comes next be stronger and better and better educated than it was before the DPJ debacle?
あの、まず安倍政権のアベノミクスについて一言申し上げたいと思います。
Well, first of all, I would like to make one comment in regards to Abenomics.
私は日本の経済の現状というのはアベノミクスの失敗を証明していると思います。
I actually believe that the economic situation in Japan now demonstrates the failure of Abenomics.
とりわけ消費税を 8% に上げてからのこの間、日本の GDP はマイナスを続けております。
Particularly since the introduction of the 8% consumer tax, actually Japan's GDP has continued to fall since then.
まあ消費税を上げて、ちょうど1年が経過した今年の4月6月期の GDP もマイナスです。
And in fact, around 1 year since the introduction of this tax in the April to June period of this year, of course, the GDP was also in the minus.
国民の実質賃金はマイナスを続け、消費も冷え込んでいる。国民の多数に景気回復の実感はありません。
And in regards to the average people of Japan, actually, well, their everyday salary has actually continued to increase. And I believe that the majority of the people of Japan would not feel at all that they are seeing any benefits from Abenomics.
あの安倍政権はまずアベノミクスのこの現状についてきちんと総括すべきです。
And so first of all, the Abe government should actually really evaluate Abenomics in a very honest way, I believe.
この総括なしに新三本の矢とか言っても、これは国民の期待を集めることは決してできません。
And without doing this and just going forward and announcing, shall we say, the new third arrow and so on, it would be impossible to actually have the people on board with this.
あの、野党のはどういう教訓を学ぶべきかというご質問でした。
And in regards to the lessons of the opposition?
まあ、民主党政権についてはいろいろ考えるところがありますが、今話し合っているパートナーですので、今日はコメントを控えたいと思います。
Of course, there are many things which could be said or considered in regards to the Democratic Party's government, but because they are now our partner in these discussions, I would like to refrain from making a direct comment.
ただ、私たちの提案している国民連合政府について言いますと、国民の皆さんにはっきりとした約束を示す、すなわち戦争後の廃止、 立憲主義民主主義の回復、これはシングルイッシューではありますけれども非常に大きなイッシューです。この約束はをしっかりお示しし、これを必ず実行する。でこれは日本の政治の部分の問題ではありません。根幹土台を立て直すという大事業ですから、これをしっかりやり遂げたら、まあ、シングルの問題であったとしても国民の政治に対する信頼は大きく回復することになることは間違いないと考えております。
However, in regards to our proposal for the national coalition government, while this may be a single issue, it is also a very major issue. And so if we are able to make a clear promise to the people, that is to repeal the war legislation and to bring back Japan's constitutionalism. If we're able to make this very clear to the people, and not only this, to very certainly implement and realize this as well, then I believe that this would not affect just one part of Japanese politics. But because it is such a major cause, if we could succeed in this, this would actually very much contribute to recovering the Japanese people's trust in politics as well.
Okay, Jimbo-san, please. Okay, and then you're next.
テリー・ジンボーでビデオニュース、日本語で質問いたします。ビデオニュースのジンボーです。まあ、あれだけね、野党が、まあ、大反対をして、抵抗をした法案が通った、まあ、翌日っていうか、まあ、その日ですよね。その日に C さんの方からね、まあ、国民連合政府構想というのが発表になったにもかかわらず、例えば特に民主党はですが、どうも我々の感じとしては、じゃあとにかくあの法案を潰すんだって言ってきて、じゃあやろうと言ったらば、なんか非常に、まあ、ある意味冷たい反応があったんではないかと印象を持っている方は多いんではないかと思います。そこで質問なんですけれども、特に岡田さんはですね、まあ、選挙協力については否定はしなかったけれども、政権を共にすることについてはいろいろハードルが高いということを、まあ、C さんにも言われたというし、我々も記者会見で言っていた。そこでその、まあ、民主党岡田さんが言われたような共産党と政権を共にすることについての、懸念ですね、その何か懸念をどうも持っておられるようだと。その懸念、もちろんこれ向こうにも聞かなきゃいけないことなんですが、その懸念とはC さんのが共産党の側から見ると何だとお考えになっているか、そしてその懸念を払拭するために共産党としてはどのようなことをされる用意があるか、ね、それに関連して、すみません、この1点だけ聞かせてください。同じ関連で、先ほどまあ、国民連合政府は憲法の枠内で、まあ、一応現状維持で憲法の枠内でという言い方された、まあ、憲法の枠内で言ったときに、共産党がその日米安保とか自衛隊をその憲法の枠内と考えるかどうかという問題が出てくるので、この仮に共産党が政権に入った場合、その間に有事が起きた場合に、自衛隊、それから在日米軍への出動要請というのはされる、という理解で良いのか、1点、それからもう1点、体質的な問題で、民主党の、ごめんなさい、共産党のよく言われている民主集中性の問題については、共産党としては今後、連立を組むという上で、どのように対応されていくのか、すみません、ちょっと長くなりました。
うん、to summarize, there were three aspects to this question. First of all, in regards to the impression that many people may have from the response from the Democratic Party of Japan to this proposal, which was of course made very quickly on the same day that the war legislation was put forward, despite the fact that there was such resistance. It seems that Mr. Okada has said that they would not deny cooperation for elections, but he's stated both publicly and also in his discussion with you about very high hurdles which would be in place to forming a coalition together. And this is perhaps related to the fact that many may have concerns about forming a coalition with the Communist Party of Japan. Of course, this is something that you may have to ask of them, but I would like to ask what you or the Communist Party's position of what kind of concerns may exist to form, that other people may have in regards to forming a coalition with the Communist Party, and whether or how you might deal with this, what kind of effort you may be willing to put forward to get rid of this. The next point is in regards to your comment about conducting activities within the framework of the current constitution. Of course, whether the Communist Party considers the self-defense forces and the US-Japan treaty itself as part of the constitution or not is a question. But in the case that there was an emergency situation to occur while the coalition government was in administration, would this mean that you would actually ask for help from the self-defense forces or the US military based in Japan? And in regards to the third question, this is in regards to what kind of cooperation you would envisage for the policy of the DPJ in regards to, I'm sorry, democratic centralism, which is proposed by the DPJ.
まずですね、岡田代表との会談で、岡田さんの方から民主党内にですね、 政権を共産党と共にすることについては、まあ、ハードルが高いと難しいという議論があるというお話はありました。
First of all, in regards to discussions with Mr. Okada, he stated in his discussions with me that within the DPJ, there are discussions occurring at the moment about whether there would be high hurdles in regards to forming a coalition with the Communist Party.
私の方からは、なぜ、連立政権が必要なのかと。で、これは安保法、戦争法を廃止し、立憲主義を取り戻すということを本気でやろうとすれば、どうしても必要になるというお話をいたしました。
And my response to this was, well, why is it indeed that we are saying that a coalition government is necessary? And this is, if we are serious about repealing the war legislation and recovering constitutionalism, then this is what is needed.
まあ、その上で、まあ、共産党との政権を組む上でのどういう懸念があるのかという、そこまで話し合ったわけではないんです、これは。
And we did not continue discussions to talk specifically about what kinds of concerns may exist to forming a coalition together with the Communist Party.
これは今後の話し合いの中で率直にそういう点についても話し合っていきたいと思います。
And this is something which I hope to be able to very directly discuss together with the DPJ from now.
まあ一般に言えば、例えば天皇制をどうするのか、あるいは自衛隊をどうするのか、日米安保条約の問題をどう扱うのか、こういう問題への懸念もあるかもしれません。
Of course, there may be concerns in a general sense about, for example, how the issues of the imperial system, the self-defense forces, and the U.S.-Japan security treaty should be considered.
それは一つ一つ丁寧に私たちの考えをお伝えすれば、政権協力の障害にならないということが理解いただけると思っております。
And I believe that if these are one by one dealt with, and if we are able to convey our positions or our proposals sufficiently for this, then there would not be an obstacle to forming a coalition based on this.
いわゆる共産党アレルギーということがよく言われます。
Of course, we often hear people talking about, you know, allergy to communism.
私たちもアレルギーをなくしていくための努力をします。
And we will, of course, make efforts to also get rid of this allergy.
しかし、これは、過去のいろいろな問題を乗り越えて、アレルギーを乗り越えて未来に向かって団結しようということを、そういう立場で話し合っていきたいと思います。
However, I hope that our stance in the discussions from now will be looking at how we can overcome various issues of the past, overcome such allergies, and look at collaboration towards the future together instead.
次に国民連合政府が安全保障の問題にどういうふうに対応するかというご質問でした。
And in response to your third question,
先ほど説明したように、私たちは日米安保条約の問題について言えば、凍結という、政権の対応としては凍結という対応を取るべきだと考えております。
First of all, in regards to the U.S.-Japan Security Treaty, as I mentioned as well, our position would be that as a government, this issue should be frozen.
戦争法は廃止した上で、その上で残ってくる法律が当然あります。
However, of course, after the repeal of the war legislation would be successful, there would be various legislation remaining.
例えば自衛隊法は残ってきます。
For example, the bill in regards to the self-defense forces.
ですから当然ですね、九博不正の主権侵害が起こった場合にはこの政権は自衛隊を活用するのは当然のことです。
And therefore with this law still in place, this would mean that if such a case were to occur, then the self-defense force would be put into action.
それから我が党の民主集中制についてご質問がありました。
And in regards to the democratic centralism of our party or our position on this, sorry.
民主集中制というのは私たちは特別のものではないと考えております。
We believe that this in itself is actually not something particularly special.
それは自由に民主的な討論を尽くし、決まったことはみんなで実行するという当たり前のことだと考えております。
And we believe that it is well the obvious thing of conducting free and democratic discussions and deciding together how to go forward.
ですからこの原則というのは近代政党として当然のものではないかと。私たちは考えております。
And so we believe that as a modern political party, this principle is actually something very natural.
そして何よりもこの問題というのはそれぞれの党内の党の運営のあり方の問題です。
More than anything, this is actually related to how each party conducts their own activities, to their internal aspects.
その種のことはお互いに連立政権を作る際に障害にしてはならないし、また障害にならない問題だと思います。
Therefore, I believe that these would not be and should not be obstacles to forming a coalition, looking at the different aspects within each other.
私たちも他の野党の内部的な意思決定の問題について口を挟むようなことは一切いたしません。
We of course also will not be making any interventions or making any comments about the decision-making processes within other political parties.
党のあり方は相互に尊重し合って、一致点で結束するということが大事じゃないでしょうか。
So I believe that we should continue to have mutual respect for how each party goes about their internal business and work together on the one single issue joining together.
Okay, thank you. The lady in the grey jacket here. And can you just try to keep this to one question?
Yes, okay. 日本語で質問させていただきます、香港フェニックステレビのリーです。今日のテーマとはちょっとやや異なることになりますけれども、今日本の中でもですね、中国が、ユネスコに対して南京大虐殺の、記憶遺産の申請の件で話題になっています。でこの日本政府の対応としては、今後、政府としてはそのユネスコへの拠出金の停止、あるいは削減、あるいはユネスコの改革を求めようとしていますが、日本共産党がこの日本政府のスタンス、どのように評価して、もしそのようなことになれば、日本にどのような影響があるのか、そしてこの南京大虐殺、日本でいわゆる南京事件についてですね、改めて日本共産党の虐殺であるかどうか、そしてその死亡者数について、どのように見るか教えてください。
I would like to ask a question on a slightly different topic, and this is in regards to the issue of the UNESCO listing in the memory of the world of the documents relating to the Nanjing massacre. The Japanese government has, of course, announced its stance of considering stopping or reducing its contribution of funds to UNESCO or calling for the reform of UNESCO. I would like to ask the Japanese Communist Party's position on how to evaluate the Japanese government's stance on this, what impact you think that it might have, and also the Communist Party's position on whether the Nanjing massacre was indeed a massacre and what kind of numbers of people were killed in this.
私は日本政府が自分たちの意見が入れられなかったからといって、ユネスコへの拠出金を減らす、あるいはなくしていく、そういう方策を取ることは国際社会の理解を得ることはできないと考えております。
I believe that the stance of the Japanese government, where it's just for the fact that its own opinion was not accepted, to talk about either reducing or cancelling its contribution of funds to UNESCO is something which the international community will not accept.
UNESCO という大事な国連の機関に対して、自らの意見が取らないからと拠出金を減らすというのは、いわば強権的なやり方であって、取るべきではないと。
Therefore, because the UNESCO, of course, is a very important United Nations agency, so just for the reason that it did not match its own particular opinion, going forward or calling for reduction of funds and so on is something, well, a very forceful and very wrong position to take.
南京虐殺については、私たちはこの虐殺の規模、数、これはさまざまな推計がされております。ですから党として、何人というふうに認識を持っているわけではありませんが、虐殺という事実があったことは動かしがたい歴史的事実です。
And in regards to the Nanjing massacre itself, of course there are various estimates in regards to the very scale or also the number of people who were killed in this. And as a party, we do not have a position on the specific numbers in case. However, the massacre itself, I believe, is a historical fact which cannot be denied.
これは当時の日本軍関係者のさまざまな証言、等々を見ても明らかです。
This is something which is, of course, also clear when you look at the testimony from various Japanese military individuals and so on from that time also.
それを否定することは許されないと考えております。
And therefore, I believe that it is not forgivable to deny this.
Okay, this lady here, please.
My name is Kaoru Kozuka from the Nikkan Gendai. 日本語ですみません。お願いします。
どうぞ。
日刊現代の小塚といいます。先ほどですね、お答えされた中で次回の参議院選挙の選挙協力について、32ある1人区が、絶対的に重要であるということで、その32のすべてで野党が選挙協力を行えば打ち負かすことができるというふうにおっしゃってました。でこの32、1人区ですね、1人に集中させる場合、過去のですねデータ等々を見ますと、共産党の人がですね32の選挙区で1人も出ないということになる可能性というのが、あるかもしれないんですが、要するに、32で、共産党の候補者1人もいないという状態になってでも、結果的にですねなってでも、選挙協力をして、やっと、自公と戦うと、そういう必要があるという、そういう、覚悟というかですね、そこまで持っていらっしゃるのかどうか、そこを確認したいと思います。
I would like to ask a question. You referred to the next House of Councillors election and the particular importance of the 32 single seat electorates. And you talked about the importance of, if there was cooperation in these seats, then it would be possible to defeat the LDP and Kuomintang government. However, if we look at the past figures and so on in regards to these seats, this could mean if the candidacy was focused on one particular person together from all of the opposition parties, this could actually mean that there would be no Communist Party candidates in all of these 32 seats. Is the Communist Party prepared to go so far to actually even have no Communist Party candidates standing in these 32 seats in order to go forward with this coalition proposal?
私たちが選挙協力と言っているのはまさに協力であって総合的なものです。
The electoral or electorate cooperation we are discussing is of course cooperation is the key word.
すなわちある選挙区では私たちが立てないで、他の候補者を押す。
Therefore this would mean that in some particular seats then we would not put up our own candidates and would instead put our backing behind candidates from other parties
ある選挙区では他の野党が立てないで私たちを押してくれる。
However, in other seats, this would mean having Japanese Communist Party candidates standing and the other parties supporting or putting their backing behind these, our candidates.
あるいは無所属の候補者を共同で押すということもあり得るでしょう。
Or it could also mean support for independent candidates who are not affiliated to any political party as well.
いずれにせよ選挙協力ですから、これは総合的なものです。
But of course, cooperation is in essence a mutual thing.
そういう相互の協力を本気になって追求してこそ一番力が出ると思います。
And it would only be if mutual cooperation is seriously pursued, then this could actually go forward.
Go back to, okay, this lady first here, and then Joel Teddy.
Svetlana Vasiliuka, freelance and Meiji University. I have a question about the TPP agreement that was just recently signed. It's already attracting a lot of controversy, even in the United States. Well, considering the most recent democratic debates, we could see that even Hillary Clinton, who used to support this agreement, she's not now actually pushing it forward. However, immediately, once it was signed, Abe-san declared that it was a very important, great agreement. It's going to create lots of opportunities for the Japanese society as a whole. What does your party think about it, you individually, and do you share overall agreement with the other opposition parties on the future of this agreement and significance of this agreement as a whole? Thank you.
私たちはこの TPP については厳しく反対するという立場で一貫しております。
In regards to the TPP, our party is consistently and strongly in opposition to this.
この間の大筋合意された内容を見ても、日本側がですね、一方的に譲歩に次ぐ譲歩をやっているという内容になっています。
And if we look at the contents of the recent agreement as well, and we look at what is put forward from the Japanese side, we can say that it is in very many ways not particularly one-sided or one-way.
とりわけ、一円の重要な農産物について、関税の撤廃、あるいは輸入の枠の一方的な拡大、これを図られようとしているのは日本の農業にとっては破壊的な影響に及ぼすことになるでしょう。
Particularly in regards to the contents of the tax on certain produce or also the increase in imports of certain things also, this would have a very destructive effect on agriculture in Japan.
この TPP については、国会決議が自民党も含めて挙げられております。
And in regards to the TPP, within the LDP, they are talking about the agreement within the Diet. Sorry, the resolution within the Diet.
まあ、重要農産物の5項目については、これは適用外にするというような内容になっております。
And the contents of this resolution is saying that, well, it would not be applicable to the five major items or categories of produce.
で、今回の大筋合意の方向というのは、この国会決議にも明らかに反するのではないかと考えております。
Therefore, I believe that actually the agreement which was recently made actually goes against the contents of this resolution.
で、我が党以外の野党も、この国会決議には、に照らして TPP の今回のような決着には、賛成しかねるという方向でこう一致しているのではないかと考えております。
And in regards to the position of the other opposition parties as well, I believe that it would be possible to reach agreement on the conclusion that the agreement which was made recently in regards to the TPP is something which should not be supported.
アメリカの国内の状況を見ましても、今大統領選挙の過程で、民主党の中でもサンダース候補が絶対反対を唱え、クリントン候補も反対を言うという状況があります。
And within the United States domestic situation as well, and the current process for the presidential elections, as you mentioned, the three main candidates from the Democratic Party and even Hillary Clinton herself is also saying this cannot be agreed with at the moment.
私は TPP の方向というのは、米日の日米の中心とする多国籍企業が各国国民を収奪する、そうした体制だと考えております。
And we believe that the current direction of the TPP would mean that, well, United States and Japanese will very centralized multinational corporations would really be taking over this whole situation.
ですから関係の各国でも反対の声が国内的にも上がるでしょう。
Therefore, also within other related countries, there will be voices of opposition from the people being raised as well.
私は国際的連帯も強め、TPP 交渉からの即時撤退、そして批准の措置も含めて、断固反対するという立場で臨みたいと考えております。
Therefore, in regards to our position, I believe the international solidarity on this issue is more and more necessary and very much needed from now. Also, working together to withdraw this current agreement as well and to take measures in regards to this is what is being called for at the moment.
多国籍企業の利益を最大化する国際経済秩序で、ではなくて、各国の経済主権と各国国民の生活を最優先する新しい国際経済秩序が必要だと私たちは考えております。
And so the kind of economic system globally which prioritizes making maximum profits for multinational corporations should be replaced with a system which instead prioritizes at its highest the lives and the situation of the very people and the citizens of these countries. So this is the new kind of system which is needed now.
Okay, coming very close. あと1問、2問。Okay, we'll have to go to Teddy, then Joel. And
just a confirmation. ビデオニュースの神保です。すみません。先ほどの、フォローアップなんですけども、国民連合政府ができたときに自衛隊の出動に要請することは共産党としては構わないと、ただ、日米安保は凍結するという表現されたんですが、要するにそれは在日米軍への出動要請というのは、この国民連合政府有事の際には、行うことに共産党は反対するという理解でよろしいんでしょうか、そこの1点だけクリアお願いします。
I would like to ask a follow-up from my previous question. You said that the situation within the coalition government would allow activities made by the self-defense force, but when you discuss about the freezing of the security treaty discussion, would that mean that the Communist Party in such a coalition government would oppose a request for action of the U.S. military base in Japan in the case of an emergency situation?
先ほど私は日米安保条約を凍結するというのは戦争法の廃止は前提にした上で現行の法律と条約の枠組みで政府としては対応すると申しました。
Previously, I mentioned when I referred to freezing in regards to the treaty, this is on the basis of assuming success in the repeal of the war legislation and looking at also taking actions based within the framework of the existing treaty.
ですから自衛隊の運用は現行の自衛隊法、戦争法が可決される前の自衛隊法ですね、これで運用することになります。
Therefore, this would mean utilizing the self-defense forces under the law in regards to the SDF, which was in place before the war legislation was passed.
日米安保条約に関わる問題ですが、これも現行の条約の枠内で対応することになります。
And in regards to what would happen under the US-Japan Security Treaty, this would also mean taking steps under the current framework of the treaty existing.
ですから、現行の日米安保条約には第5条で、日本が武力攻撃を受けた際には、共同の対処ということが述べられております。
And therefore, this would mean in Article 5 of the current US-Japan Security Treaty, this also talks about what would happen if Japan were to be on the receiving end of an armed attack and what the US role there would be.
この条約で 対応することに政府としてはなります。
So therefore, as the government, this would mean taking steps according to the contents of this treaty.
一言述べておけば、党としては、これは日米安保条約を廃棄して、日米の友好条約に置き換える、変えるという大方針を変更するわけではありません。
However, this would not mean as a party that we would make a change to our core policy in regards to this. And of course, this is working to an abolishment of the security treaty and changing this instead to a friendship treaty between the two countries.
この大目標を私たちは一貫して追求します。
And we will continue consistently this major goal as the Communist Party itself.
しかし、国民連合政府にそれを求めることはしません。
However, we would not seek to have this done by the National Coalition Government.
凍結というのはそういう意味です。
And this is what I was implying by utilizing the word freeze.
Okay, make this the last question and keep it short, please, Joel.
Yeah, my question is about Okinawa. We hear from Okinawa a lot of complaints of people, and we have seen in Iwakuni that there are some people who complain also about the noise. Those things have been happening for years and years. Now, what do you think about the decision of the Tokyo government about this Okinawa issue and the refusal opposed to the governor? Also, we are facing a lot of sophistication of military equipment today in around Okinawa by the Americans or the Chinese or the Russians. What do you think about the level of militarization that is going quite under discretion and without really being known by the public? As you know, countries watch each other, and these are sometimes similar to war preparations. Thank you.
まず沖縄の米軍基地の問題について見解を述べます。
First of all, I would like to state our position in regards to the US bases in Okinawa.
今問題になっているのは名護市辺野古に海兵隊の最新鋭の基地を建設するという問題です。
And the main issue at the moment is of course looking at the construction of the new marine base at 辺野古 in 名護.
これに対しては 沖縄県民の総意として これを拒否するという審判が昨年冥府に下されました。
And we have very clearly had the voice from all of the people in Okinawa clearly calling for this to be seized.
この総意のもとに小長新知事が生まれました。
And it was based on this all Okinawan position that Governor Onaga has come into power.
小長知事は勇気を持って公約の実行を今進めています。
And now Governor Onaga is also working for it in taking great courage in his action in order to realize the promises that he has made.
まあ最近、前知事の埋め立て承認を取り消すという決定を小長知事は行いました。
He has of course recently announced the withdrawal of the previous governor's permission for the rebuilding.
私たちこれを強く支持します。
And we very strongly support him in this.
そして小長知事はこの 決定の際の会見で日本の民主主義が問われていると訴えました。
And in his press conference on this issue, Governor Onaga also mentioned that now Japanese democracy is being questioned.
私も文字通り問われているのは日本という国の民主主義だと考えております。
And I also believe that it is very much the democracy of Japan as a country which is being held to question in this.
一体沖縄という県が島ぐるみで繰り返しノーを突きつけて いるにもかかわらず、政権がその声を一個だにせずに強権を持って新基地建設を進めることが民主主義の国で許されるのかと、これが問われています。
So in the situation where Okinawa as a prefecture is all coming together and fighting and being very clear in being against the construction of the new base, the fact that the central government is completely neglecting this and pushing forward the construction, is this something which should be allowed to happen in a democratic country? And we do not believe so.
この問題をやはり本土の我々が自らの問題として、しっかり受け止めて、沖縄の決意に日本国民全体が応えなければならないと、沖縄に連帯する戦いを日本全体で起こしていく必要があると、私たちは強く呼びかけたいと思います。
And in regards to this issue, I believe that we as people on mainland Japan also need to look at this as our own issue as well and respond to the call and the will of the, all of the people in Japan. And therefore, I am calling for solidarity from people throughout Japan in this struggle. The new construction at Nago is something which should be immediately ceased. And in regards to what to do with Futenma,
普天間の固定化をしていいのか、安倍政権はそのように恫喝をしています。And
in regards to whether Futenma should be kept as it is and so on, and the position of the Abe administration.
しかし、小長知事は理の通った断固たる反論をしています。Of
course, Governor Onaga is taking a very strong opposition to this stance.
普天間基地は一体どうやって作られたのか。
We need to consider how Futenma was indeed created in the first place. This is not something which the Okinawa people willingly gave up. And Futenma base was indeed created on the confiscated land of the Okinawan people, which was taken forcibly under the US military occupation. So in regards to whether this Futenma base, which was created on land forcibly taken from the people, so the current Abe administration is saying, well, it should be kept as it is because there is other no place for it. This is something which Governor Onaga is very much arguing against, and we also agree with him. In regards to Futenma, we believe that if we look also internationally, we need to be calling for an unconditioned return of the land where Futenma is. And this should be done not by forcing this on the Okinawan people, but instead going into negotiations directly calling on the United States to do this.
次に沖縄県の周辺の緊張の問題について質問がありました。
And the next part of the question was regarding the situation surrounding Okinawa and the military buildup.
おそらく尖閣諸島をめぐる問題だと思います。And
I believe perhaps you are also inferring to the Senkaku Islands issue here.
私たちは中国が尖閣諸島の日本領海内に公船を入れてくる、こういう物理的な力を持ってことを進めようというやり方には強く反対しています。
We are strongly opposed to any move by China to bring or physically bring in force into the Senkaku Islands area.
私はこういうやり方は良くないと、中国の定価大使にもお会いしたときに率直に我が党の見解を伝えています。And
I have also expressed our position to the ambassador of China when I have met with him, or our opposition to these methods.
ただ同時に、この緊張をもって自衛隊の海外での活動の拡大の理由とすべきではありません。
However, this should not be used as a reason to pursue expansion of the role of the self-defense forces overseas. Using this tension as a reason for this should not be allowed.
冷静に見る必要があるのは、中国は確かに中国のコーストガードの船を領海に入れてくるという乱暴なことをやってるのは事実ですが、軍艦を入れてるわけじゃないんです。
And if we look at the situation calmly, of course, it is a fact that China is bringing its Coast Guard ships into the Japanese territorial waters in this area. However, it is not military or naval ships which are being brought in.
その時に日本が海上自衛隊で対応するとなったら、相手はまさに海軍で対応するということになるでしょう。
However, of course, if Japan were to respond to this using its self-defense forces, then of course China would also respond to this using its military.
ですからこの問題というのは、そういう軍事対軍事のエスカレートにしてはならないというのが私たちの態度です。
Therefore, our opinion is that this issue should not be allowed to escalate into a military versus military kind of situation.
私たちは尖閣領土、尖閣諸島の日本の領有権の正当主張には国際法上も歴史的にも全く正当なものだという詳しい見解をすでに発表しております。
In regards to whether the Senkaku Islands are indeed part of Japanese territory, we believe that looking both at international law and also historical aspects, this is very clear that the islands do belong to Japan, and this is also something we have made very in detailed announcements also.
この問題は何よりも外交の場において日本政府がその領有の正当性を中国政府に対しても国際社会に対しても道理を持って解くことによって解決すべきだと考えます。
And because of this justification, we believe that this issue is something which the Japanese government should bring to the diplomatic table in its discussions with China and also the international community.
もちろん海上保安庁が対応することは当然ですから、この対応を必要とあらば、しっかりするということは私たちは当然だと思います。
And of course, in a certain situation, our response by the Japanese Coast Guard would be necessary, and this is something that we also believe is natural.
繰り返し言いたいのは、軍事対軍事のエスカレーションを起こしてはならないということを強く言いたい。
So what I would like to strongly repeat or emphasize is that a military versus military escalation should not be allowed to occur.
これは日本にとっても地域の平和と安定にとっても一番危険なことになります。
This would be the most dangerous thing to happen both for Japan and also for the peace and security of the entire region.
Okay, thank you, Shii-san, for your speech and Q&A. If you could give him a round of applause, please. The formation of a united opposition front would certainly make our jobs more interesting come the next election. And here is a complimentary membership to the club for 1 year.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. And just an announcement, if people can stay around at the club at 3 o'clock, we will have Kono Yohei speaking here, so maybe worth sticking around for. Thank you. And thanks to our interpreter.